There have been times in my life when I haven't worked, and I start to shrivel up inside in some way. And on the other hand, if they said, well, okay, you can work, but you can't have your family, the same thing would be
You'd
the case.
You feel empty and
I would. I have this, I guess, in a way, for all its exhaustion and difficulties, this charmed life of having a strong family life and my two little baby boys and my husband and my home and friends, and getting to be a gypsy, you know, playing these parts and opening myself up to an audience every night or in a movie. I couldn't have one or the other.
It's almost as good as it can get right now for you.
Yes, I guess, yes.
Living in New York, mm-hmm. Liam's on Broadway, you're on Broadway, yes. So there's a matching of schedule. One's not off shooting a movie in Australia.
Yes, for
the kids are here.
Yeah.
You know, you get to see each other for dinner after the respective shows.
Yes, we do. You know,
you're doing well.
It's pretty good. Life's good, yep.
Yes, yes. What reservations other than, who did you consult about playing this? Did you talk to people, your mother, did you say, should I do this, should I not? You, obviously you talked to Liam.
I wanted to do it. I asked to do it. Yeah. I offered myself for this part.
I said, me.
I'd like to do it. And then later, and then there were
problems. Did you have to convince them?
No, I didn't. I think I probably had to convince John Kander. I mean, I had the part. They wanted me to do it. But when I had to sing for John Kander for the first time, there was this deathly silence in the room. And I was thinking, oh, he's not exactly jumping up and down going, yes, she's singing great. I had a bad cold at the time. I hadn't done any vocal work at all on the score. I didn't know the songs hardly. So I'm not sure that he was entirely convinced that I could sing it. And then, so when he came back later and said, you don't know how far you've come, it meant so much. But actually, Liam and my mother had to tell me they'd shoot me if I didn't do it, because there was a moment when I thought, no, I just don't think I can.
I don't need this kind of challenge right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so aren't you glad?
I am. I'm very glad. I'm having a great time doing this. Now, it took me a long time.
Yeah, you said that the other night. I came back after the show and you said, for a while, it was difficult.
It was. It was like a sort of ride down Space Mountain. I don't like roller coasters at all.
Meaning it was out of control almost.
It was. I didn't feel in control. I felt very nervous and frightened, and so that I just couldn't center myself and feel the confidence that you really need to play this part to an audience. So I needed every single preview and more.
You get confidence by just doing it. At some moment, there comes a time in which you say,
I think so, but it's so ephemeral. I mean, there's some nights I go out there and you think, yes, that was it. That's it. That's a print. I just want to keep it, freeze it like that forever. And you go out the next night and you're not so good. That's the nature of live theater, and I suppose what makes it so exciting, that you're really never sure what exactly is going to happen. So you have those nights when the audience go crazy and scream, and the other nights when they go. And I'm a perfectionist. I drive myself very hard. So on the nights that I don't get where I'd want to be, then I get upset.
Join us online at charlierose.com.